Dark matter. The first evidence for the existence of dark matter emerged in the 1930s when an astronomer called Fritz Zwicky observed the Coma Cluster, a massive cluster of over 1,000 galaxies, all gravitationally bound to one another. Zwicky looked at how many galaxies were visible in the Coma Cluster and made an estimate of the total amount of matter in the cluster based on the mass of an average galaxy. He also measured the velocities of some of the galaxies in the cluster and deduced that many of them were moving very fast. So fast, in fact, that they should have all been able to escape the gravitational pull of the other galaxies in the cluster and escape into deep space. This implied that the cluster was much more massive than Zwicky had calculated. The most natural way to account for this was to assume that much of the cluster's mass was invisible. The most interesting thing about dark matter is not simply that we can't see it, it's that we know dark matter is not made of the same stuff as normal baryonic matter. This is actually why we can't see it. Baryons interact with each other through gravity, nuclear forces, and the electrostatic force. Dark matter, however, only interacts through gravity. That's why we see its effects on the motions of galaxies and stars, but why we can't see it directly. It does not emit or absorb light. Dark matter particles can also pass through regular matter almost completely undetected, since they don't interact electrostatically, meaning we can't touch it or sense it in any direct way. We don't know much about dark matter yet, which is a remarkable thing because it makes up 27% of all the matter in the entire universe. We've never been able to directly detect dark matter in any form. But we know it exists through its effect on the universe, especially through the orbital velocities of stars and gravitational lensing of light around invisible objects. Gravity keeps planets rotating around the sun and the solar system rotating around the galaxy. But when we observe the speed at which galaxies rotate, there simply isn't enough gravity to hold everything together. Think of dark matter as the glue that allows galaxies to generate the extra mass and gravity to keep everything together. For instance, according to standard physics, stars at the edges of a spinning, spiral galaxy should travel much slower than those near the galactic center, where a galaxy's visible matter is concentrated. But observations show that stars orbit at more or less the same speed, regardless of where they are in the galactic disk. This puzzling result makes sense if one assumes that the boundary stars are feeling the gravitational effects of an unseen mass, dark matter, in a halo around the galaxy. Dark matter could also explain certain optical illusions that astronomers see in the deep universe. For example, pictures of galaxies that include strange rings and arcs of light could be explained if the light from even more distant galaxies is being distorted and magnified by massive, invisible clouds of dark matter in the foreground, a phenomenon known as gravitational lensing. Scientists have a few ideas for what dark matter might be. One leading hypothesis is that dark matter consists of exotic particles that don't interact with normal matter or light, but that still exert a gravitational pull. Other scientists think the effects of dark matter could be explained by fundamentally modifying our theories of gravity. According to such ideas, there are multiple forms of gravity, and the large-scale gravity governing galaxies differ from the gravity to which we are accustomed. Expanding universe, dark energy. Dark energy makes up approximately 68% of the universe and appears to be associated with the vacuum in space. It is distributed evenly throughout the universe, not only in space, but also in time. In other words, its effect is not diluted as the universe expands. The even distribution means that dark energy does not have any local gravitational effects, but rather a global effect on the universe as a whole. Similar to dark matter, dark energy is a concept that was formulated to answer a question, in this case, about the universe's expansion. It was understood that after the Big Bang, the universe is expanding. At the same time, the gravitational forces generated by all of the matter in the universe should have slowed that expansion to some degree. Yet scientists have learned that the universe is actually expanding at an increasing rate. This strongly suggests that there's a force in the universe that is overpowering gravity, a force we call dark energy. Unlike for dark matter, scientists have no plausible explanation for dark energy. According to one idea, dark energy is a fifth and previously unknown type of fundamental force called quintessence, which fills the universe like a fluid. More is unknown than is known. We know how much dark energy there is because we know how it affects the universe's expansion. Other than that, it's a complete mystery. But it is an important mystery. It turns out that roughly 68% of the universe is dark energy. Dark matter makes up about 27%. The rest, everything on Earth, everything ever observed with all of our instruments, all normal matter, adds up to less than 5% of the universe. Come to think of it, maybe it shouldn't be called normal matter at all, since it is such a small fraction of the universe. What do you think? We'd like to hear your opinion in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe.